you last week, but welcome back to The Ramble. I'm your host, Brittany Dipp. The Junior Class Council fundraised with a fluff ice truck that was here on Friday after school. Hope you guys want to get some more yummy treats to support your junior class. On Saturday, the Pride of Temple City competed at Arcadia's Festival of Bands Parade. There they played and performed to an exciting crowd and judges on Baldwin Avenue. Hope you were there to support them before they go to represent us at the Rose Parade. And don't forget about our annual canned food drive. Make sure to bring in cans to your fourth period classroom soon. It will be ending this Thursday. Congratulations to our athletes out there for the end of a great season in sports. You guys all did an amazing job. But now it's time for the winter sports. Stay tuned for more information in upcoming episode, Rams. Now to Kayla for World News.
Hi, Rams. It's Kayla with your World News. This week, the federal government spent a whopping $10 million on a video game called Escape from Diab. This game is about a nightmare city where people eat nothing but junk food, and the objective is to escape the fat town. The National Institute of Health paid for the development of the game, hoping it'd be a method to combat obesity. According to Archimage Incorporated, a computer game company that received $9 million to develop the game, the story is centered around five children who must eat healthy to escape the evil King Etz, the fat ruler who forces people to eat out of the vending machines. The game was tested on about 100 kids aged 10 to 12, resulting in children increasing the amount of fruits and vegetables they eat by 0.67 servings. So next time you want your kids to eat all the broccoli on their plates, you know what to do.
Hello, hello, Rams. It's Tanya with the Q&A Corner. And the first question I have today is, what's the best thing to do with your free time? I think trying to take on a new hobby like writing or photography is really cool. Or you could go outside and exercise. Or do the complete opposite and go with your friends out to eat. There's a new restaurant called Makoji down the street. My personal favorite pastime activity is to go shopping. And speaking of shopping, the next question is, how do I dress for this California winter? I would say for you girls, putting on a simple dress with some tights and paired with a little bit of makeup and cute tennis shoes will always do the trick. And always bring a light cardigan in case it gets windy. And for you guys, you can never go wrong with a knit sweater, jeans, and your favorite kicks. Well, that's it for today, Rams. Please tune in to our next episode and be sure to keep those questions coming at our ask.fm-dragonflix. See you next time.
Hey, Rams. Welcome back to The Ramble. I'm your host, Brittany Dipp, and welcome. We missed you. It's good to be back. Oh. Hey, Rams! Okay, I'm like, am I gonna do it? That one time! Hey, Rams! Welcome back to a new episode of The Ramble. I'm your anchor, Brittany Dipp. Is this loud enough for you, or should I talk louder, or not that loud? Okay, we're good. It's fog.